Mr. Amor, Senior Amor, back where it all began. Where are we?
Yeah, we're back up at my amateur club, sorry, Hensingham Rugby League, back where it all started, and a bit weird now because this is probably the first time, Spud, that I've actually just had a little minute to think that it is all finishing for real tomorrow night. So it doesn't seem like 2 minutes ago since I was in those sheds over there and playing out on this field. It's gone by so quick, and like I say, it's took me to some incredible places. So look, tomorrow night we're really looking forward to everything that we've sort of put in over the last 12 months in terms of taking events on the road and trying to get as many fans to access some of those events and see some people that perhaps they wouldn't have seen, and it all finishes tomorrow night. It's so important that we've got these stars, the Super League coming back. For all of them, really, not just myself. You know, they all played at Maryport, Wathbrow, Ellenborough, Barrow Island, Walney, all these wonderful amateur clubs that do terrific work for the game. You know, those players will not only represent them, their families, and also the county as well, but it's important that the kids get to see these superstars of the game, if you like. You know, like Sir T. Ritson, you know, you'll have kids from Maryport playing in that under-9s little festival we've got on tomorrow, Spud.
And just for those that don't know, yeah, it's at Whitehaven Rugby.
It's at Whitehaven, yeah, it's at Whitehaven Ground tomorrow night.
And it's your testimonial.
It is. But again, though, those kids, I'll use T. Ritson for example, you know, a Maryport lad who's played semi-professional in this county and has got a shot at St. Helens. He's going to play tomorrow night, and those kids will be... He'll be dreaming that's them one day, you know, playing at St. Helens and Cumbria alike as well. So our job as players is to inspire, motivate, whatever you want to call it, the next generation of the game. And hopefully tomorrow night there'll be some kids out there, whether they'll be playing in that little festival beforehand or in the crowd, that can continue to dream and hope to play elite level rugby, whatever that looks like for them.
Okay. Now tickets are available on the gate. It's 18 quid adults, 15 quid
concession. And £10 for kids. We try to do the early bird ticket scheme for just to encourage people to save a couple of quid and get tickets bought. We've sold over, you know, I think it's nearly 1500 tickets we've done now, and we're expecting a walk up on the day of the game, as always with Cumbria. There's 2000 walked up last year, so hopefully there'll be a fantastic crowd. We look to carry on to build that Cumbria brand, and you know, not just for, you know, on the back of last year, it was 13 years ago since, you know, Cumbria played at Whitehaven in that Gary Purden Memorial game. We've got their family down there tomorrow. I think it's important that, you know, I wanted to show not only their family but the people of Cumbria that we haven't forgot about those, you know, those 12 victims that lost their life on that day last time the game was played down there. So we're honouring those and recognising those, and also we've got the Logan Holgate Lion Heart Fund, which is very, very right up in the, I'm at the heartbeat of it right now at Hensingham Rugby League. We've got the two boys there, Fletcher and Ellison, as we remember one charity and we pass it over to another. So there'll be guys down there doing bucket collections for the Logan Holgate Fund. So if you see any of those Logan Holgate fundraisers, fund collectors, whatever you want to call them, make sure you dig in and give what you can for them. So you know, we want some good to come off the back of this testimonial game as well.
Good. What time does it start? What time's the gates open?
The gates are open from 5:30. Obviously, again, the all those 8 amateur clubs from all across Cumbria, from Barrow to work it into Whitehaven, they'll all be participating in that festival from 6:30. It's about a 20-minute festival to let them have a run around before the lads warm up at 7:00. So gates open from 5:30, and the game kicking off at 7:30 as well.
And is it true that you're going to be singing before the match?
No, that's our kid's job, isn't it? No. I cannot sing, no. I'll just be able to just about play rugby league tomorrow night. But I won't be singing, Spud, that's for sure.
Yeah, the majority of the players, how many is there? Right.
There'll be 21 of us playing tomorrow night.
Right, yeah. And there's loads of Barrow lads.
There is. We've got a fair representation across the game. We've got about 5 lads from Barrow. I think there's 4 or 5 from Whitehaven, 3 from Workington Town, and the rest are made up from Super League and, you know, the other championship clubs they play at. One thing, I didn't really have a selection. I wasn't a part of the selection process and stuff. You know, what we said to Paul Carreri, the coach, is we want to continue to be taken seriously. If we don't win games as Cumbria, then we can't really generate interest and we can't expect people to support us. So we've only been beaten once since 1995, I'm led to believe. And that was against England Knights the year after in 2011, I think it was. We got beat 26-12. So we want to pick the strongest squad available. You've got Championship in Whitehaven and Barrow, and then the working lads are in League One. So, you know, Paul Carreri, John Tigoli, you know, look, obviously I have to play with it being my testimonial, but how many minutes that looks like, I do not know, you know. So, but the rest of it, the minute I start to hurt us as a team, they're going to get me out of there and make sure that the rest of the lads are ripping in and doing the job that they're made to do. So, look, we had 37 blokes put their hand up, Spud, so it's always... You know, it's unfortunate that some people are going to miss out, but equally for not only the game, but also for the fans, the paying fans, they want to see the best team available, don't they? That's a given. So obviously the coaching staff made some calls, and this is what we've gone with tomorrow night. So, you know, we look to look after Wales by bringing, you know, we've got them staying in working, and then we've got them in a restaurant and stuff like that, and we're hugely thankful for them putting their hand up and answering the call about this testimonial game. But as a Cumbria team, we want to make sure that whoever we play in the coming years, yeah, well, of course we want to do. You know, we Spud. We want to entertain. Do you know what I mean? That's what we're here to do. We're in the entertainment business, so we want to entertain. And we want to make sure that next year when we get a game that, you know, we can possibly play like an Ireland or a Scotland or whoever it may be, and just bring elite level rugby back to the county, because every time it has been, it's been well supported. You know, St. Helens, 6,000 last year. Jamaica, 4,000 last year. You know, Scotland in the Four Nations, 7,000. The Gary Purdom game, 5,000. So the appetite for elite level rugby is very much here. But, you know, so it's an opportunity again, like I started with, for these younger kids and fans of the game to see their locally bred stars, you know, whatever division they're playing in.
Okay. Score prediction?
Oh, good one. Not really thought about that. I was fun. Yeah, look, I think if we play to our potential and we make it uncomfortable for them, I think we get. I think we come away with a 12-point win.
Oh, 12-point win. Right, so that's going to be your last game.
Yeah.
What was your first game?
What, professionally?
Yeah. No, well, no, amateur level.
Out here, I think it was Egremont away on a Friday night in the second team. And I always remember one of the lads, as we were walking over, he kicked me by the road as we were walking from the changing rooms out towards the pitch. He dropped my pants right round front of everyone. So yeah, it was a little baptism of fire as a 16-year-old. But you know, I loved it. I absolutely loved it. I was playing second team on a Friday night, first team very quickly on a Saturday, and then under 18s with this great club, Ensingham, on a Sunday. So I spent all of my teenage sort of, you know, from 15, 16 onwards. Well, not all my mates played rugby, but we sat in there, and that's where we learned to become young men, I think. So. Yeah, I always. You get brought up in places like this. People will know who's played the game, exactly what I mean. You know, particularly those that go on to play sort of 18s and 16s and into the first team. This is where you're surrounded with lads and brothers for life, if you want to call them that as well, because they help bring you up, I think. Well, that was certainly in my case. Do you know what I mean? But you know. Amazing, love it.
You know what? Well done. Congratulations for saying that tomorrow when you smash the taps.
No. Just before we sort of shoot off, but I honestly want to say, like, for me and my family, thanks very much for not only your support that you're gonna, you know, hopefully everyone gets down there tomorrow night, but in whatever way you've supported, whether it's through my testimonial, my career, whether you've just wished me well when I've not even been around, then honestly, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much.
Oh, I'm gonna start crying.
I get out of it.
So anyway, to top it off, tomorrow night, Whitehaven Rugby League ground, the Lel Arena, Derechi, right? Get down there from 5:30. And it's Cumbria v Wales, and before that, it's all the kids having a bash.
Yeah, like I say, gates open at 5:30. The kids are going to be on there from 6:30. The lads will warm up at 7:00. We'll kick off at 7:30, and then hopefully, in true Cumbrian fashion, we can all, you know, walk out the ground or stay in the ground, drink plenty of beer, and all take a deep breath after it all.
Happy days.
Cheers,
man.
I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only